Anyway, plenty of power for the triple mowers, butterfly mowers, whatever you want to call them. So they're just in a low-lying area there, probably not going to get it all. You'll see some rashes, which is never a good sign. Usually always a wet ground there. Anyway, I see he's got a young passenger with him today, a young lady. So my chances of getting on in the cabin with him are virtually nil, I would imagine. I can't imagine going to kick her out to let me in. I wouldn't think. So they're just mowing what they can, but leaving the wet part alone, I think. So I've had the drone up, hopefully not okay. Usually just have it up for 5-10 minutes at the most. Gives me enough footage to for the video that I make for YouTube. So I'll probably missing the tractor. I haven't seen Ali for such a long time. It must be 6 months anyway. Whether that's a good or bad thing, I'm not sure. On his part anyway. Cutting around 9 meters, 30 feet. So I don't get to film too many triple mowers, but here we are, butterfly. So I used to have a Fendt 722, I think it was, on the mowers, but it's now a 828, I think anyway, but I'll be wander down and see what's what. Although he shouldn't be that long till he's up here, coming back up to the gate, he'll be finished. So it's quite awkward for the rake man, but anyway, it must be done. There's a wet part there, maybe a corner, well in the middle it should be okay. Oop, doesn't sound too healthy that. I'll get both tractors in together. I'll head away in 5 minutes. Not really the best part to be filming, to be honest. Probably a few molehills down there, but what I can see, it's probably causing the mower to change its tune.
in a misty, clouded haze of a memory that now feels untrue. I used to feel disguised, now I leave the mask behind, painting pictures that aren't so blue.
True. So somebody bring up the lights, I want you to see.